In a veto message sent to both houses of Congress, President Duterte enumerated his reasons for rejecting the security of tenure bill, a measure that was intended to fulfill his campaign promise of ending ENDO, or end of contract, formerly known as labor-only contracting, an abusive labor practice that leaves workers jobless again after 6 months or less. According to the president, labor-only contracting must be prohibited, but legitimate forms of job contracting should be allowed. Businesses should also be allowed to determine which jobs should be outsourced, especially if it will contribute to the efficiency of their operations and will not harm workers. The president also believes that expanding the definition of labor-only contracting would put management in a difficult situation and will also affect workers in the long run. But the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, or TUCP, argues the version of the Security of Tenure Bill that reached the president has been watered down and is far from being detrimental to employers. What is clear now is that 9 million ENDO workers will continue to suffer, according to TUCP estimates.
Ang ENDO at contractual work ay modern form of slave labor. At yun po ay magiging poverty trap para sa lahat ng ating mga manggagawa.
TUCP is also convinced that the SOT bill was sacrificed in order to give way to the second package of tax reforms, which will also impact employers and investors. For labor group Centro na Nagkakaisa at Progresibong Manggagawa, the president's veto is a betrayal of his campaign promise to the people. Meanwhile, Senator Joel Villanueva, who authored the Senate version of the bill, feels that the decision is a sign that the more powerful prevailed once again over the week. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines reveals Malacañang asked them to summarize the impact of the bill on jobs and investments a day before the State of the Nation address. According to the report submitted by ECOP, 236,697 workers in the manufacturing industry alone may lose their jobs since these are contracted out, and not all workers can be absorbed or regularized by the contractee. Future employment from foreign investors, such as Japanese pledges of 16,000 jobs, will likewise be compromised since some are also in the manufacturing industry.
I think they realize naman ng Malacañan na maraming mawawalan trabaho at maraming mawawalan investment kung ipapasa to.
Both ECOP and the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry also believe the president is not reneging on his vow to end illegal contractual arrangements and has in fact already been delivering on his promise.
This security of tenure is in a bit redundancy. You know, we have the Labor Order 174 that already addressed the ENDO issue, okay, wherein workers now are protected. They can just be let go every 6 months. And the service provider are also tasked, you know, with paying all their social securities, you know, whatever. It's part of the order. So they're very well protected.
According to House Minority Leader Bienvenido Abante and Albay 2nd District Representative Joey Salceda, the bill will now have to be refiled before the 18th Congress. The Gabriela Partilist and labor groups TUCP and Centro are also planning to come up with a stronger version of the bill. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.